So welcome back to the second part of the video. We continue with where we have left in our first part. And in this case, we have been talking about the question number two. So with that, you have understood, we need to go to question number three. So the question number three. So this one we are told that Oliver Shavus, the cards. Shavus, an ordinary card of the pack of the 52 cards. If he then draws a single card at random, find the probability that the card is a king, a spade, a black red card, and a prime numbered card. So this is what the card that you're talking about. So usually a pack. You should have the how many? You should have a 52. You should have the 52 of them. So you need to be able to understand how they are arranged. So in this case, in the case of the arrangement, I'll be using the guide to show you how they are. That's how they are. How we have three of them in terms of the caliber. Like we're going to have the category of the clovers there. We are going to have the category of the spade. Then you're going to have the category of the diamond. Then you're going to have the category of what? The category of the hearts. So meaning in that pack card, which is having 52 cards, they are going to be, they are generated in four styles. We have the black ones together and the red one together. So whereby you have the clovers and the spade are all black, then the heart and the diamond are going to be red one. Then how are they denominated, these cards? So that's what I'm saying. But in this number three, you need to be able to understand again the cards that traditionally used there. So you have here the diamond. Diamond. Then we have the hearts. You have the hearts there. In the hearts, you have the hearts. You have the clovers. That's the clovers. Then we have the finally the spade. The spade. So in this case you see we have different colors. So this one only. This is red. This again is red. And then this one is black. And also this one is black. Then you are saying total of them are 52. So if you say 52 divided by 4, that is going to give you here you're going to have 13 cards. Here you're going to have 13 of them again. And here you're going to have 13 cards of them. And here 13 cards. So how are they labeled, this card? This card I have the, out of the 13, the first one is known as the A. Then you have the 2, you have the 3, you have a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then from the 10 we have the jump. We have the queen, Q, and then we have the king. So that's how the denomination of these cards are going to be. So these are the jump that I'm saying. So if the jump, this is the J, which I'm using, they're going to be four of them. So one is going to be four, diamond. Then the next one is going to be for the hearts. The other one is going to be for the clovers. Then the other one is going to be for the spade. So every card here, if it is the A, there are four of them. If it is two, there are four of them. All the way up to the queen, there are going to be four of them. Then again for the king, they're also going to be the four of them. So that is the way the question, the way the cards are supposed to be understood. Then from there, what is the examiner telling us? The examiner is telling us what is the probability of getting a king. So what is the probability are you going to get a king? So the king is going to be K there. The king. So here you have the king. So you have the three of them, one is missing. So you can see the king, they are going to be four again. So you have one for spade, then you have one for diamond, then you have one for clovers, and you have another one for hearts. So the king, they are supposed to be four of them. So in this case, you are saying, what is the probability of getting a king? So you understand that a king can come from the diamond, a king can come from the hearts, can come from the clovers, or from the spade. So in the case of the theoretical probability, we have agreed it is the favorable number of the outcomes over the total over the total possible number of the outcome. So you're saying the whole pack, The whole packet is going to contain how many? It's going to contain 52 cards in this packet. So if that is the case, then what is going to be the probability that if you shuffle them, if you put them together and then you try to shuffle, this is what we call by shuffling them. If you try to shuffle them here, that way. That's what we call shuffling them. If you shuffle them and then you pick one of them, so what is going to be the probability that you are going to get a king as your card? So there we are going to focus on the what you have said, that is the probability of getting a king is going to be equal to the favorable number of outcomes, over the total possible outcomes. So in this case, how many are the favorable for the king? There are going to be four of them. Over the total cards, how many are they? They are 52. Over 52. Again, we advise you, make sure that you leave your answer in a simplified form. Don't leave your answer if it is not in simplified form. In this case, you are saying, so by 4, 1 by 4, 13. So therefore, the probability is going to be 1 over 13. So 1 over 13 is going to be our answer for the probability of getting a king. Then in the next case, now part B, we're asking you, if you shuffle them, that's what I'm saying, that shuffling the cards. If you try to shuffle them, that way. So what is the probability that if you pick one of the cards after you shuffle, it's going to be a spade? So you can be able to see what you have said, that in the case of getting, probability of getting a spade, you need to identify how many spades are there. And you have said, these cards are in four denominations. Each denomination has 13 cards. So meaning we should be having 13 cards for the spade. So if you want to get the probability of getting a spade, then it will be the ones that are favoring the spade. It are going to be 13 of them. Then over the total, it is going to be how many? It's going to be 52 cards. Then finally, you simplify. And when you simplify, you get your answer. So by 13, 1, then by 13, 4. Answer becomes 1 over 4. Then in part C, we are told that find the probability of getting a black and a hot. A black card. Not a black red card, it is a black card. So what is the probability of getting a black card? There you're given the 3 marks there. So there is what I told you, you need to be able to know the colors of this denomination. You have the diamond and the heart are red in color, but then the clovers and the spade are black in color. So the probability of getting a black card is going to be the sum of what? The sum of the card for clovers plus that for the spade over the top. So the card for the clovers, how many are they going to be? 13, plus the other one are going to be 13 over the total, which is 52. So this gives us 13 plus 13, then that is 26. What is 26? Divided by 52. Then you see here by 26, 1 by 26, 2. So the answer becomes 1 over 2. So the probability of getting a black card is going to be 1 over 2. So far so good. So you can be able to see the trick that are going to come with this question of the cards. So you need to be able to understand them. Then if you use them during praying, when you are trying to participate in some games, so make sure that you understand everything so that when it comes to the exam, you can be able to tackle the question without necessarily having the cards with you. Because you are saying, in an exam, the cards are not going to be provided for you, but you have to get the knowledge of how they appear. Then, part D, we are told that the probability of getting a prime numbered card, and the probability of getting a prime number. So that is knowledge now give us, we have said all the cards are going to be labeled from A up to the J, Q and then. So what is going to be the probability that you are going to have a card as a prime number? So in this one, you have to know that these, all of them are located depending on the number that you are going to be having there. So if a card is going to be a prime number card, it. So be able to understand the definition of it so that you know what is a prime number first. Prime number. So a prime number is the number that have how many factors? The factors are going to be 1 and itself. So meaning the number is going to be a prime number. Then it must have two divisible factors, two divisors. That is 1 and itself. That's why we insist that 1 is not a prime number and the smallest prime number is 2. So it is the prime number of the cards which are showing the case of the prime numbers. And you understand there's going to be 2 is one of them. Then 3 is a prime number also. 4 is not. 5 is a prime number. Then 6 is not. 7 is a prime number. 9 is not a prime number. And then again, 10 is also not a prime number. Then the others, you have the J, Q, K, the amount number there. So these are the only one that you're going to have. So in one denomination, you're going to have only a total of 4 cards. So meaning, if it is the case of the dam, you're going to have 4 cards which are prime numbered. That is the case of the what? Dam. Same case will happen to hearts. The other case is going to happen to the clovers and then the spade. So the total number of the prime numbers are going to be 4 multiplied by what? 4 multiplied by 4. And this one is going to give us what? 16 cards. 16 cards are the ones that are going to be prime numbered. So then that one is going to be 16 over the total, which is going to be 52. Then you can see by 2, 8, then by 2, 20, that is 26, then again by 2, 4, then by 2, 13. That the probability becomes 4 over 13. So that's the concept which I'm trying to talk about in the case of the prime numbers. So in my last part, I'm going to show you the assignment where it's going to be there on a video. So I'm going to play as you wind up our lesson. You can ask my director to play that video. That video involves the assignment that you're going to focus on it. So it's going to be a worked assignment. So it's a question. So you pray as you pose it.
In this video, I'll show you how to calculate theoretical probability. The first question asks, a sphere is divided into 8 equal sectors, number 1 through 8, as shown. What is the probability of spinning an odd number? Let's start off by counting the number of odd numbers. 1, 2, 3, and 4. There are 4 odd numbers, and there are a total of 8 numbers.
So that's what you're saying. So this is the one that I would be wanting you to be able to do. Before you find the answer, the answers are going to be there. But once you pray it, I want you to be able to stop it because I will be sending it. That you can be able to find the question before it is worked out. Then from there, you're going to get all the answers to confirm whether you have gotten the concept of the theoretical probability. Otherwise, with that, I wish to end my lesson. Do have a good day. Do have a good day. And enjoy the next part of the day. And with those few remarks, I am out.